Kamusta yung cheesy intro na ginawa natin dyan, ha?
Pasensyahan nyo na ako, hindi ako magaling na editor.
So welcome sa Team Bomac edition ng ating vlog entry. So yeah, as you can see, I was trying to feature nga yung drift car that I've had since 2004 actually. No, 2006. I actually got this car through a friend of mine. Actually, kaklasik ko siya sa Pilipinas, si Kevin Carbonell. I guess it was his grandpa's car back in the days, tapos napamana sa kanya. Then in 2006, I was able to purchase it from him. I'm gonna post some pictures along the way sa habang kinukwento ko sa inyo yung kotse para at least ma-explain ko naman yung itsura niya before. This has came to 3 or 4 revisions already kasi original car was a black, you know, it was black ang original paint niya. After that, nung I got the sponsorship through Justdrift and Federal Tyres, the car was painted green livery para yun nga dahil sa sponsor nga namin. And then after, when it was painted green and white, that was most of its life when I drifted the car for, I don't know, like 6 straight years I think with Justdrift and Federal Tyres. After that, we had a facelift, yun na nga yung nag-convert tayo ng front end. We went to the S14 front end, S14 Koki. Yung medyo balitang ilaw. So tinanggal na natin yung flip-up lights niya. And then the car was painted red. You know, during that time, I was still running the stock SR. Yun yung Japanese motor na originally came out with this car sa Japan nga, so we did the swap. The life of the red car wasn't very long. I believe, siguro, plano siya, napinturahan siya, I think back in 2012. And then, the last time I ever drove that car was in 2014 All-Star Bash. Doon nga yung sumabog yung makina niya. But actually, it wasn't me, it was a good friend of mine who drove the car, and you know, sa kanya kumatok unfortunately yung makina. Then I think after 2014, the car sat for a while. I think the car sat from 2014, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. So I would say mga 2020 na, I think, bago siya uli namin na panda with the newer motor na nakuha ko from a good friend again. But also that didn't last. After the, you know, with COVID and all that stuff, even 2020 or 2021, I have to really look back, but just forgive me, but it's around those times na we finally decided na it's time to step out of the SR. It's either I go with a 1J or mag-VVA tayo. But I think I was able to get lucky and find yung V8 swap. So for a good price, and then yun na yung ginawa namin. We decided it was time to change. And at that point, we obviously did went to the LS1. I believe it's a LS1, LS6 conversion kung ano man yung ginagawa nila. So most of the things na ginagawa sa kotse, lahat ng labor, tsaka pagbubuo ng makina, tono, lahat yung daddy ko ang gumagawa. Ano, siya yung pinaka main mechanic, technically sponsor ko sa kotse na yan. And I'm only driving, you know. So for the most part before I even started sa Exotics Racing Speed Vegas, this was my experience. Ito yung dinidrift natin sa sasakyan. But before this car, for I think 2 or 3 years, I was actually using a 1986 Corolla. And I still have that car. We'll get to that part. Papakita ko rin sa inyo yung sasakyan na yun. Nandiyan pa siya sa backyard. So, that's gonna be sa next entry ng vlog.
So, pakita natin sa inyo yung engine niya. Pasensya na kayo, medyo hindi siya malinis, pero it works, I guess. So that is the engine swap, sa V8 LS. So it has Siki mounts, naka Siki headers na rin siya, Hali Terminator X na wiring. And yeah, there's really nothing special. It's just put it on, we started, and yun na yun. So, ang dati pinag-aaralan din niya kung paano itono yung sasakyan. We changed fuel, yung ano nga, fuel injectors niya and stuff like that. Pero, and then we did get the chase base radiator, which is siya yung parang universal na up and down, pwede mo siyang baliktarin. So, if I do decide to go back to SR or 1J in the future, I can still use that radiator kasi na ano siya, custom napapalitan. Tsaka, it's fully tucked. So malinis, tignan, maganda yung space. All motor, no turbo, no supercharge, nothing. Okay na yan. So I think kahit pa paano, this should push at least 300 horsepower man lang.
Check out the interior.
So yeah, this is the interior. Yung dash, napagawa ko siya last year din. Dami na kailangan lilinisan. Kasi may mga crack na siya, common dito kasi it's a 1991-92 model, so yung dash niya nag-crack na siya, then syempre nabibila din sa araw. So pinagawa ko to kay Penguin John, thank you sir for fixing that for me, shout out sa'yo. Suede na siya para yung reflection niya hindi ano, hindi bumabalik. So yeah, that's my Nardi steering wheel. This is a special size, it's a 340mm. Perfect siya for me, I like this a lot. I've been a Nardi fan. I think I have at least 6 or 7 Nardi steering wheels na na-collect ako over the years. E-brake was also just added in 2020, yung ginawa yung V8 swap niya. Well, actually before the V8 swap, but it's the same year nung naka-SR pa siya, yung huli kong SR, sinubukan ko to. And wow, what a difference, you know, hydraulic e-brake instead na doon tayo sa ordinary na to, kasi nagkakaproblema na ako sa regular e-brake dati. Okay siya, but I'm still not really used to it kasi kahit sa work walang e-brake yung Hellcat, so pinag-aaralan ko pa siya. But yeah, other than that, it's super simple, you know. Yung cage niya is Safety 21 Cusco na pinamana pa sa akin to ni Charlie Ong 5. As you can see, welded door bars. Yan, dinagdag lang yung door bar niya. Nothing special, bright seat, reclinable sa passenger para pag nagsasakay tayo. And then my seat is a very old Z3L kasi mas mataba ako nung bata-bata pa ako. It's a very special car for me. This is where it all began, you know. I mean, at least, you know, of course, including the Corolla, tas ito. Ito rin yung nagtawid sa akin parang college degree ko para makuha ko yung trabaho ko ngayon sa Speed Vegas na drift driver ako sa kanila. So yun, inabot na tayo ng gabi. Anyway, I think for the most part, na-cover ko naman yung fast forward ng kwento ng S13 and from back in 2006 to now 2023. Umaandar na siya uli. I mean, it's running. Pero since nung V8 swap, naka-isang test kami sa work sa Speed Vegas. Tapos, nadala ko siya sa isang event. So, this coming June 2nd, actually, meron na naman isang night event ng Vegas Drift. Dadaling ko dun yung sasakyan. Dadaling ko dun yung S13 para makapag-test tayo uli. And since nandito rin yung brother ko from Manila, so at least makita niya yung auto. Sana, you know, wish us luck na walang issue. At sana tuloy-tuloy yung practice namin for that night. Summer na kasi dito sa Vegas, kaya medyo mainit na during the day. Kaya night events na siya. So,
yeah, stay tuned. Hopefully, ma-cover natin yung event. I can do some in-car footage nitong sasakyan, pero it's gonna be night, so it's gonna be tough. Pero susubukan pa rin natin. We'll see. So yeah, that's the episode of Team Bomac cars. So sinimulan ko muna sa S13. Even laruan lang throughout the year. Stay tuned lang kayo, and hopefully you guys are enjoying this episode. Parang kahit pa paano, it's a history of what I've done in the last 24 years here sa Las Vegas. Share lang natin yung mga natutunan natin throughout the years, and kung ano na yung ginagawa natin at this point. Talaga naman may kuliglig pa yun. Pasensya na, inabot ng gabi. At na-realize ko wala pa palang closing ng aking video. So, this is the closing part. So, again, thank you for watching. And sa mga subscribers, all 200 of you guys, I appreciate you. And God bless. And be a blessing to one another, okay? Have a good night. Thank you.